Well, happy Friday, everyone. It is another hot day, but dry as we go throughout the afternoon. Temperatures getting us back into the 90s across the upstate with some wet weather heading our way Sunday through Tuesday. So unfortunately, Father's Day, we are looking at some rainfall for most of us. And those that don't get wet on Sunday have a pretty good chance on Monday and Tuesday before everyone dries out by the middle part of next week. Let's get you caught up with the latest with our tropical cyclone number 3 getting ever so close to the coast right now, expected to basically move across eastern, southeastern portions of Louisiana, heading into tonight or possibly during the overnight hours. So making landfall between, say, 8 or 9 o'clock tonight or possibly just after midnight, and then moving up into the southeast, giving us some rainfall. So right along the coast, this is definitely where we will have the highest amount of rain here, especially on the coast of potentially Louisiana, but Mississippi, Alabama, and Florida, anywhere from 10 to 12 inches of rain will be the maximum amounts, but a foot of rain is a lot. So you can imagine the flooding that's going to be happening there. A little bit closer to our area, most of the rainfall as of right now looks to be right around Greenville and further south. Now, if this particular system stays on its current track, it might shift a little bit, so make sure you stay tuned throughout the day. But here you see, as we go into Tuesday and Wednesday, we've got a cool front that's going to come through across the region, and that will also bring some widespread rain. So here's where this tropical system is right now. You can see some of these outer bands beginning to move very close to Grand Isle, Louisiana, and then eventually up into New Orleans and possibly into New Iberia. But some of these outer bands beginning to move across portions of Alabama and Louisiana. Right now, though, across our area, we are still under the influence of a ridge of high pressure, which is parked just to the northeast of us. It is on its way out into the Atlantic Ocean. So really, after today, the guarantee of dry weather slowly goes away as we get into some increasing clouds tomorrow. So here you go. Let's take you through the next few hours. You could see tonight and very early tomorrow morning, this system will be making its way inland, and then it very quickly begins to move across portions of Mississippi and Alabama and right into Georgia. And then here you see Sunday morning, we might get some rainfall out ahead of the main system, but the gusty winds, which could be 15, 20, 25 miles per hour, not looking at anything too strong in terms of winds, this will begin to move through as we go into the afternoon time frame. And again, right now, looking like most of it stays to the south and east of most of our viewing area, but still some scattered showers possible across the mountains and even into Travelers Rest and Pickens and back into Wahala. And again, this is the current track. It's been fairly consistent all morning and early afternoon, but that could still change. So just make sure you stay updated. Then here you go. Here's Tuesday. We've got a cool front that's going to come through. This will also generate some widespread rain across the region before high pressure builds in behind this. And we will actually have cooler, less humid, dry air again by the middle part of next week. So not too bad, right? Low 90s today, low 90s tomorrow, despite those clouds increasing. Sunday, we're looking at some rainfall Monday and Tuesday as well. And then Wednesday and Thursday right now looks dry and a little bit cooler.